Welcome to the second talk hosted by Guan Kan Journal in collaboration with the University of Western Australia. Today we'll be talking with Xiao Lu, but first I would like to introduce who is here with us today in Perth. We have Dr. Darren Jorgensen, Senior Art Historian of University of WA, Tami Xiang, artist and editor of Guan Kan, Sam Bidge, editor of Guan Kan, and myself, Jessica Cottam.
Hello, everyone. Hi.
Xiao Lu is a highly respected Chinese contemporary artist who famously fired a gun in the 1988 Avant-Garde exhibition in Beijing. After officials closed down the show, Xiao fled China to Sydney and has lived between Beijing and Sydney since then, making a series of works and performances around the world and writing the novel Dialogue. Xiao has remained at the cutting edge of art around the world for the last 30 years.
大家好，欢迎来到今天肖卢女士的讲座。这里是观看中国现代中国当代艺术思考期刊主办的关于中国当代艺术的线上讲座。我们这个主办团队包括 Darren Jorgensen 西澳大学的教授Sam Beard Jessica Cottam and myself 和我是这个观看的主编。今天我们邀请中国著名行为艺术家肖卢女士参与今天的线上讲座。肖卢1962年出生于中国杭州，1979年就读于中国中央美术学院附中，中途休学，1984年毕业，之后就读于杭州浙江美术学院油画系，1989年来到澳大利亚，他在1989年的现代艺术大展上一举成名。之后来澳洲后1997年回到中国，直到最近他又回到澳大利亚。今天是肖卢女士来澳大利亚之后的第一个公开活动，欢迎肖卢女士，谢谢。你可以开始。
听得见吗？还是就大家好，我是肖卢。很高兴今天受西澳大学艺术学院的向晨美之邀，参加观看中国当代艺术思考线上系列讲座。今天讲座的主题是身体和意识转换的内在因素是什么。前几天我跟向晨美讨论这个题目的时候说，其实这个问题是我自己一直在困惑的一个问题。所以我今天是把这个问题抛出来，希望通过今天的讲座能够从中得到一些答案。前两天我编了一个视频为这个讲座，所以说现在呢，先看一下我的视频吧。我编了一个12个行为的视频。
Hello everyone, my name is Xiao Lu, and the topic of today's talk is what are the internal factors in the transformation between body and our mind? A few days ago when I was discussing the topic with Tami, I said this was a question that I was confused about. So I threw it out and hope that I could get some answers from this today. First of all, let's watch an edited video. And there are 12 performance art edited. Thank you.
有年龄限制。年龄限制的话，就是到一定的时候，因为我到医院咨询，44岁是他们接受人工受精的最后一个年限，所以这个时间的紧迫性也产生了这个，在这么紧转的情况下产生这个作品的一个原始动机。
你们任何人都可以拿，拿完以后自己放。
比企图把男性工具化，就是嘛，而且他所以男性们在挣扎。
萧鲁女士，你是否愿意嫁给自己为妻，忠于自己的想法，无论海枯石烂，无论沧海桑田，永远和自己在一起，你愿意吗？大声地告诉我们。
我愿意。
今天他结婚了。
刚才看了一下我的行为，那个行为需要看水平吧，有一个感官的那个对我的作品有个认识。下面呢，通过一些图片 PPT 的图片，然后具体介绍一下我的作品，然后探讨一下身体和意识转换的内在因素是什么。
We just to say some of my performance, now you have a rough visual impression on my work. Now I'm going to show you some pictures of my work, and then we discuss what are the internal factors in the transformation between creating art with body and creating art with consciousness.
1989年二月五号，我在北京中国美术馆中国现代艺术展上的那一枪，一直是一件比较有争议的作品。对话作品源于年轻时非常个人的情感性侵经历。从作品的形式上可以看到，一对男女在打电话，中间悬挂的电话筒，预示着男女无法沟通的一种状态。最后射出的子弹是情感压抑发出的怒吼的枪声。
The shot I did on the Chinese modern art exhibition in the National Art Museum of China in Beijing on February 5th, in 1989, was a controversial work called Dialogue. The dialogue was based on a very personal experience of emotional abuse and sexual abuse. At my young age, from the form of my work, a man and a woman were talking on the phone with the phone hanging in the middle, indicating that they cannot communicate. The last shot was an angry, the shot I did was an angry expression of repressed emotion.
对话的装置作品是1988年我大学的一件毕业作品，同年刊登在美术杂志的封底。当年油画系，因为我是88年毕业的，油画系出现了这么一件作品，还是引起了很大的关注，所以许多本系和其他系的老师都来看我这件作品。其中以工艺系老师宋建明的一段对话。是枪击这个想法的来源。当时他就是来看我的作品，一见的作品就说：“哎呀，这件作品太干净了。”他说需要破一破。我们就一起在聊怎么破。这才谈到速度的时候呢，就提到了枪。你知道那时候老师很多人来看作品，看完就走了，说几句话就走了。但是呢，宋建明老师走了以后呢，打枪这个想法呢，我一直去不掉。这可能跟做这件作品的初衷有关。然后1988年曾经向浙江射击队的一位朋友借枪，在展览开幕前他被允许借枪3个小时，但一时没有找到我，因为那个时候也没有手机嘛，所以这个想法就没有实施。1989年作品对话入选中国当代艺术展，然后向朋友借到了枪，所以这个想法才可以完成，所以说这个作品就是这么一个过程。
The installation work of Dialogue was my graduation work in 1988, which was published on the back cover of Fine Art magazine in the same year. That year, I was studying in the oil painting department and created this work, which attracted lots of attention. Many teachers from our department and other departments came to see the work. The idea of shooting came from a conversation with Song Jianmin, a teacher from the technology department. He said this piece was too clean, as soon as he saw the work. The mirror needed to be broken. We were talking about beer and we were talking about speed, and he mentioned guns. After the teacher Shun Jianmin left, The idea of shooting has been stuck in my mind, which is related to the original intention to make this work. In 1988, I actually once asked a friend from Zhejiang shooting team to borrow a gun. On the opening day of the show, he was allowed to lend the gun to me for 3 hours. But the idea didn't realize because he didn't find me in time, because, you know, at those days we didn't have phone. In 1989, the work dialogue was selected into the Chinese modern art exhibition. I borrowed a gun from a friend and completed this idea, shooting my work.
我在北京东城区拘留所被关押了4天释放。展览的第二天，就展览是2月5号开幕的，就是2月6号，纽约时报就以标题 Police in China Close Art Show After Artist Shot Her Work， 就这个标题报道了这个消息。之后呢，国际国内的媒体都相继报道了。应该说这件作品因情感而创作的作品所引起的社会政治效应完全超出我当时做作品的心态，尤其是事后看这件作品的关键词1989对话北京枪击，以1989年发生在北京天安门广场上学生要求与政府对话以及最后镇压的枪声。所以呢，在纪委百科的介绍上，对话被称为天安门事件的第一枪。
After the shooting, the gallery was closed and I was released from Dongcheng District Detention Center after 4 days. Just the next day after the opening of the exhibition, the New York Times headline posted, Police in China closed art show after artist shots her work, reported the news, and then the international and national media reported it. It should be said that the social and political effect caused by this work, created by emotion, is completely beyond my mind. When I made this work, especially the hand sight, the keywords of this work, 1989, Beijing dialogue shooting, and 1989 happened in the Tiananmen Square event in Beijing happened. The dialogue, the students demand dialogue with the government, and the gunfire of the final crackdown. So in the introduction of Wikipedia, the dialogue is called the first shot.
1989年底，我来到悉尼，我的个人生活与事业好像进入一段迷茫与停滞期。直到2004年争作者，对话作者权的时候，我才对自己从1989年到2003年这段时间进行了彻底的反思，使我慢慢走出不敢面对对话的心理阴霾。有兴趣大家可以上网到香港大学出版社的网站购买《对话》这本小说，有中英文版，是香港大学2010年出版发行的。这本小说写出了我为什么不敢面对《对话》这件作品背后的真正原因，就是不敢面对自己年轻时的 Me Too 的经历。我顺便说一下，这本小说的翻译阿基波莫堪斯今天也来到了现场。
When I moved to Sydney at the end of this year, my personal life and career seemed to have entered a period of confusion and stagnation. It was not until the year 2004 that I fought for my right to be the author of dialogue that I made a thorough reflection from 1989 to 2003, that I slowly walked out of the mental haze of not daring to face the dialogue. If you are interested, you could go to the website of University of Hong Kong Press to buy the book Dialogue in English and Chinese, published by the University of Hong Kong in 2010. The novel describes the real reason behind why I was afraid to face the book dialogue, face the dialogue, which I was afraid to face the experience of my youth, that the experience I was, the sexual harassment. By the way, I should mention and thank my translator, Mackenzie is here. Archibald Mackenzie is here tonight.
15从1989到2003，就是我要面对对话这件作品，要就是当时要争作者权嘛，就是要有一个，好像是像对自己说一个仪式一样的，所以我就有一天看着对话作品中那个背对观众的，我刚才看的对话那个作品是背对观众打墙的嘛，我就对自己说，我要，我就把这个身子好像转过来了，对自己说。我要面对自己，要面对自己的十五年这件作品里，来，也就是原来就是从这儿来。
After writing the novel in 2006, I felt very empty and meaningless to life. There was a strong desire to have children because of the loss of emotion. It was difficult to enter into the relationship between man and woman. So I thought of the idea of IVF. I think it's wrong.
Wow.
Sorry. They died in, I was not into. Oh, okay. So, when I go back to Beijing and I made the work 15 Gang from 1989 to 2003, it was a virtue for me to confront the work of dialogue. I turned around and said to myself, I have to face my 15 years.
2006年我写完小说之后呢，整个人感觉特别空，对生命呢感到没有意义。那时候，当时呢，我就是有一个强烈的愿望，想生个孩子，可是呢，对情感的失落呢，一下子就很难进入男女关系，所以呢，就想到了人工受精的念头。正在这个时候，北京长征空间的卢杰来找我，要去延参加一个长征计划的活动，并希望我能做一个作品。 精子呢，就在这个特定的时间产生的。我特制了一个冰箱，然后准备了12个瓶子，让参加活动的与会者可以自动捐精。我还准备了一个手提冰箱，准备带回去做人工受精，但是结果没有一个人给我精。After
writing the novel in 2006, I felt very empty and meaningless to life. There was a strong desire to have children. Because of the loss of emotion, it was difficult for me to enter into a relationship between man and woman. So I thought of the idea of IVF. At this time, Lu Jie from Beijing, Long March Space, came to me to participate in the exhibition of Long March Project in Yan'an and asked me to make a piece of work. So sperm was created during this particular period. I made a special refrigerator and prepared one and two bottles for the participant to donate sperm automatically. I also prepared a portable refrigerator to be able to bring back to Beijing for IVF, but no one donated any sperm to me.
2009年2月5号是中国当代艺术展，1989年的中国当代艺术展20周年，北京艺术界的一些人呢，准备了一系列的活动。 就在那天，他们准备了三个场子，一个是北京农展馆，还有一个是北京今日美术馆，还有一个是北京墙美术馆。 可能是怕被封吧，就准备三个点，然后准备被封吧。结果第一个被封的就是北京农展馆，当天一大早呢就把那个门全部锁上了，然后策展人高明路只能在门口宣读一份表示抗议的发言。第二站呢是温普林策划的在今日美术馆放七宗罪的视频，结果警察呢赶到现场，要求把我在对话中的枪声全部去掉。你知道当场消掉枪声已经不可能了，最后呢大家只能看一个没有声音的七宗罪的默片。第三个场子就是抢美术馆，我的作品昏在那里登场。当时现场的便衣很多，策展人就跟我说我的名字很敏感，也许做不成了。可能是一个彩车的，就婚礼的彩车开进美术馆，所以呢他们就没当回事，以为是哪家的新娘要借这个场子结婚。婚这件作品呢虽然是在这个特定的时刻做的，但当时我做作品还是没有什么社会意识，那个时候正在纠结一段情感关系，所以这件作品的出发点还是跟情感有关。
On the 5th of February 2009, it was the 20th anniversary of the China Modern Arts Exhibition. Some people in Beijing prepared a series of art activities. There were three events on that day: Beijing Agriculture Museum, Beijing Today Art Museum, and Beijing War Art Museum. Maybe they were afraid to be in lockdown. As a result, the first one to be shut down was the Agricultural Exhibition Hall, which was shut down early that morning, leaving curator Gao Min Lu to read a statement of protest at the in front of the door. The second stop curated by Wen Pulin was a video of seven scenes at today's art gallery. The police came to the scene and asked me to remove the sound of the gun in the dialogue. It was impossible to eliminate the gunfire sound at that day. At the end, we could only watch a silent film. The third venue was the War Art Gallery, where my work Marriage was presented. At that time, there were a lot of plainclothes police. The curator told me my name was too sensitive, may not be able to do. Maybe a wedding float a wedding float coming into the gallery. So they didn't take it seriously, thinking the bride just borrowed the venue to get married. Although the work Marriage was made at this particular time, but I had no social meaning when I made the work. At that time, I was still struggling with the emotional relationship. So the start point of this work Marriage was still related to my personal feeling, my personal love.
前面提到的精子和婚这两件作品呢，很多时候呢都被说成是女权主义作品，还有对话与社会政治关系就更大了。但这三件作品的出发点都是情感，结果与作品的初衷的反差是我早期作品的一个悖论。2019年还做了两件与情感相关的作品，什么是爱？对，同年高明路策划一派展览，我做了两颗青铜子弹，有点调侃自己从1989年那一枪开始到现在就自己做的作品做的一些作品总是歪打正着。
So the three sorry 肖老师你再说一遍，这个我没听到。
前面提到的精子和婚两件作品很多时候被说成全体作品。一句话。
The two work, marriage and the sperm, was related to my personal feeling. And actually, then I made two gun bullets. Gaoming Lu think that also have social meaning, but actually it's just a coincidence. I didn't mean to have some social comments on my work.